I'm Richard Elkins and I'm the President of the Board of General Purposes of Freemasons of Victoria. And I'm delighted to be joined at the Think Pink Living Centre in St Kilda Road by Irene Hendel, who's a founder of Think Pink and an iconic figure in the Think Pink Foundation. Good afternoon, Irene.
Good afternoon, Richard. It's lovely to be here.
It's lovely to be having this conversation. How many years has the Think Pink organisation, now foundations, been in existence, and what's the journey that Think Pink has been on with Freemasons Victoria?
Well, we became a foundation in 2004, having raised funds in the general community since 2000 as a volunteer group. So we became a foundation in 2004. I had had breast cancer and I felt that we should have our own place, a place that was going to be a sanctuary for women to come and be supported and cared for the year of treatment that they all go through invariably, which is initially at the time of diagnosis, surgery, then radiotherapy and then chemotherapy, which takes at least 1 year of their lives. And most importantly, going through that year, I wanted us to be there to support the women after that year. Because most women can't go to work, so financially, the impact for most of the women that we see in their families is enormous because most couples go to work. What we do here is support them in many, many programs that we have. And most importantly, I should mention that they're welcome to come here for 2 or 3 years after their initial diagnosis, because a lot of women are very vulnerable after that first year. They think they may have had a return of their cancer, which actually doesn't happen at all. But we're here to support them with all the issues that they may have that have been created through that 1 year of trauma, which is what it is, and to support them for the 2 years or 3 years, for whatever it takes, to still come in, be part of the programs that we have, to be counseled, which is the most important thing that we do here, by our breast cancer nurse, whom Freemasons have funded since the day that we opened the Living Centre.
So Freemasons Victoria has been part of the journey since the very beginning.
From day one. Daniel Andrews, who was the Minister for Health at the time, came here and opened the centre because of its uniqueness in so much as it's a free facility for all women in the state of Victoria. And Freemasons Victoria stepped up immediately when they knew that we were opening the centre, and they provided the funds for our breast cancer nurse, which they have done throughout all these years, and here we are now, 7 years later.
It might seem unusual for a men's organisation, such as Freemasons Victoria, to be supporting what, I guess intuitively, is a problem experienced by females.
Well, that's a wonderful question. And it is a beautiful miracle, actually, that this has happened for us, because 1 in 9 women in this country will be diagnosed with breast cancer. Men are also in the firing line of it. 2% of men in this country are diagnosed with breast cancer, a genetic position in that particular instance. But the wonderful thing is that with Freemasons, because in our history we did fund 60 breast cancer nurses scholarships in rural Victoria for remote places where women could see a breast cancer nurse. That's what we did before we opened the centre here. But it's wonderful that Freemasons saw us, what we were doing, because 1 in 9, as I mentioned, are diagnosed currently in this country with breast cancer. When I was diagnosed, it was 1 in 13. So it's the impact is enormous.
It's a growing problem.
Oh yes, you know, all of us are affected by it. It's either our mother or our wife, our daughter, our sister, our friends. It's all around us. And I must say, since we opened here, it's not an old woman's disease. We have women coming here that are in their 20s. Every generation of women come here seeking our help. And they seek our help because they've heard about us, obviously, through hospitals. A lot of hospitals refer their patients to us, which we're proud to be there for them. A lot of women come to us through their general practitioners at the time of diagnosis, which is such a wonderful thing for them, because that is when they really need to be counseled quite extensively as to what is lying ahead, and knowing that they can come here every day and be counseled by our breast cancer nurse and join in to our different programs. We have three separate programs. One is for women that are initially diagnosed, so specific programs around those women. Another group of women that are going through treatment, programs all around that time and that journey. And then women that have cancer that is advanced.
So what's the value of Freemasons Victoria association with Pink Pink Foundation? Is it simply the brand, the money, or is it actually more than that?
Oh, it's more than that. It's more than that. Because, you know, having been in Victoria and raising funds for Victorians, Freemasons coming into our lives as a male institution was like manna from heaven for us, because all of those men, some of them, mostly, probably all of them, know someone with breast cancer. They felt that they wanted to be a part of our journey because they too are affected by breast cancer. The other thing that we did implement here 4 years ago was our Supporting Blokes program, which had never existed in this country for any cancer patient. The partners to be supported, to feel, you know how men tend to internalize things together.
Yes, we've been conducting a lot of conversations recently about that.
Well, men do internalize things, and obviously they're under so much stress when they have a diagnosis of cancer with their wives or their mums. So we decided 4 years ago that we would implement our Supporting Blokes program, which I might add hospitals are now looking at after we implemented this 4 years ago, which is a good thing. And we meet every two or three weeks. They come in here after work. And because what's in the room stays in the room, and because they're all in the same position, they really open up here. And the beautiful thing that happens all the time with these groups of men is that there's always someone in that group that you connect with, and they go on to support one another as their family goes through the journey of what their wives or their family members are.
So it's really the network that Freemasons Victoria brings.
Correct.
And that network of conversations that then arises.
Correct. So it's, you know, it's just been a miracle. We don't know where we would be without Freemasonry.
And presumably Think Pink Foundation leverages considerably their financial contributions of Freemasons Victoria.
Well, you know, as I said before, it's like manna from heaven for us. It takes us a lot of money to keep the centre open because it's free. We have so many programs that we offer free of charge to everyone that comes. We have accommodation upstairs, which was the caretaker's old apartment. And we pulled everything out, and that becomes now a beautiful space for rural women to come and stay in while they're going through treatment, which can be 6 to 8 weeks. They can stay there free of charge, which is another wonderful thing that's happened so we take care of a lot of royal women.
Well, I'm glad you mentioned that, because coming from regional Victoria myself, one often hears that, I think Pink or other like charities, perhaps they're only really relevant to those living in Melbourne. But in fact, I think you're saying that not only is it accommodation, but the very genesis of this organisation was in regional Victoria.
Correct. You're absolutely spot on. It's we've always been mindful of country women and their families, as Finn Pink has gone through so many years supporting Victorians.
Thank you. We've been talking with Irene Hendel from the Think Pink Foundation about the importance of the Think Pink Foundation, I guess, to the fabric of community health in Victoria, and the wonderful partnership that's existed for many years between Freemasons Victoria and the Think Pink Foundation. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Richard, for taking the time to come in to visit us today.
Pleasure.